The innumerable, tireless and perennial search, survey and service of all humans of various parts of the world is only to endeavor and establish the management process of their lives. So, today's topic is the essence of life of all human beings, all advanced people, because except human beings, somehow all the other species, due to their inherence and adherence to nature, they used to manage their lives, provided that they are not disturbed by human beings. So the life management is the essence, is the vitality and destination for each and every human being in the globe. Especially in this era of development and progress, more they realize, just as they realize the value of the shadow when they are moving around red hot sun. As the management skills are being eroded and alloyed by means of unwanted desires and delusions, now they crave for the real management of their life more than what they had in the pre-civilization years. To start with, basically all living organisms, they have a survival mechanism. The survival mechanism is bifold. It has functional mechanism that is embedded in security. How to execute the functions? What are the external resources that are required for execution of the biological function? And how to be against the hurdles or the external factors or obstacles that could intrude the process of biological functioning? So this survival and defense mechanism, how to live and how to continue or withstand one stage of life amidst hurdles. This type of instinct, they only in advanced status, they gained super speciality in the name of skills branded as administration, governance and management. So all of these various skills what we see now, they have blossomed from the basic survival mechanism which consisted of the functional and defense status which is embedded pre-inhibitively in each and every organism of God's creation. Now this management, it was started in the year of the academic recognition as well as development to deal with people, to manage a lot of people, to manage a lot of activities, to manage resources. So whenever there is multitude and magnitude, whenever there is a testoon of varieties wherein we have to amalgamate everything for a common productive cause, the science of management emerged. How to handle people, manpower, resources, financial management, trade management, foreign trade management, international business management. And the same thing has emerged in now, you see, now we are being asked by some universities to frame a syllabus for MBA temple management. Now there is hospital management and IT administration and IT management is there. And even after one or two decades, it may not be surprising if we have MBA in house management, children management, fees management, etc. Because whatever we have gained through tradition, we have gained these things through tradition. Now we are in a pitiable state to gain the same thing through teaching and training. We had these instincts in our inheritance. Now we have to go for reference and rehearsals. So this shows how deplorable and degradable the status of human being and how pseudomorphic the structure of the so-called science and technology and its development that we boast that we have now. So we can understand these things. So to repeat it for easy grasping and understanding, whatever we had by inference, the same inherent is replaced by reference and rehearsals. Whatever we had through tradition, the same thing must be now replaced by teaching and training processes. So now life management, what do you mean by life management? It is managing one's own life. Very simple. But what is life and what is management and how to execute it? According to Shastra as well as the modern biological explanations and elucidations, life is nothing but it is connected with periodicity. It is connected with the tenure. It is a tenure contract. According to our traditional wisdom, life is the soul body contract. It is a contract of the soul with the body. And according to biology, it is a contract of the driving force, which is there in different forms of systems, organs, there tissues and channels, with a perfect organism. So an organism driving force, or a soul body or a spirit body contract, that sojourning period or tenure is what we call life, number one. And life has various other modules to study. One is the design, life design. Second is the desire. Third thing is the demand. Fourth thing is the duty. And fifth thing is the destination. These five things we used to call it as 5 Ds, or pentastructural dimension of spiritual sojourn inside this mundane sheath or coil. The design is how we have to live by means of the systems of central nervous system, digestion system, circulatory system, various other systems are there. This is the design of life. Then desire of life. Then what do you want? Demand, what others want from you. Duty, what you ought to do. Destination, what is the end of this process? Is the completion the conclusion, or there is a repatriation possibility by which there is a cyclic chain by which perpetually you have to go through this process, or there is an end after the death? So biological death includes brain, blood death and functional death, and eschatology is a philosophical division that deals with life after death and repatriation, etc. Innumerable these things are governed under the system of destination. So these five major things, the design of living, the desire, the demand, the duty and destination, we have to understand in life management. The design is preset. All the other things we have to understand in life management principles. And third thing, you know that basically we have read in our books also, social sciences, that food, shelter and clothing, these are the basic amenities of life. And no doubt it is very, very common, and you know that food, respiration and shelter is common for all organisms. They used to have their own things. But clothing, it is just the primary agent which distinguishes the human beings from the other species. And there are innumerable things that are the distinguishable factors which are very rarely found now. But clothing is a very visible and conspicuous distinguishable factor which differentiates human beings from other people. Now also we see a lot of cartoon characters and pets which are wearing sophisticated clothing more than the human beings also. So these basic amenities, they have expanded. They have expanded. In the course of this expansion, new products are informed.